As you guessed, I'm back out on the bank. My hair's still bald today. I'm just gonna come here and basically see what I can do. I'm being here for about 8-9 years maybe, something along them lines anyway. It's completely changed from the last time I was here. I mean, last time I was here there was pads over that far side and they're not here no more, so yeah, it's all changed. And there's bivvies here as well, which is something else that has changed. There never used to be any night fishing here, so I'm assuming you can night fish it on a ticket, I believe. £10 to fish it all day. Don't know any rules really, apart from obviously no barbless hooks only. That's as far as I've got. Like, don't know anything about the bait, any tackle that you're allowed to use like that at the moment, until the bailiff comes round in a bit. So yeah, my plan was, speaking to one of the lads that I know that peg 30 was kind of like a good peg to go for, so I'm going to go into peg 30, but it was reserved for the night angler tonight. Downside really, to be honest, reserving the pegs, I think it's not ideal. Well, someone like myself who just comes down for the odd day, it's sort of like limits to where you can go really, but I suppose it's one of them things, isn't it? So I came to where I normally fish, where he used to normally fish. I'm funny enough, where I caught my first ever double figure carp. So this is sort of like revisiting the home, so to speak, like a homecoming. But yeah, so basically the idea today is just to come out and try and catch anything, because I've only caught a fish that probably still had egg sac attached to it. So that's my goal today, trying to catch a decent, an alright carp. But speaking to a lad down there, all he's had all night is two carp and a couple of tench. I'm not sure about the lad over there. Some lad turned up as I got here, he went round the other side. But no one's up this end really. Another reason why I want to come up here, because the angling pressure up here is going to be nil, like non-existent. From when I used to fish here last time, no one ever used to fish here at all. Basically because it was literally back there, it was just full pads, so you couldn't fish there anyway. For some of you that don't know where Hareston Hall is, it's in Ormskirk, it's basically a golf course with a course fishing lake on it. It's a decent lake. I seem to have a lot of ducks there getting frisky scenes out spring. So yeah, back from the honeymoon, ready to go at it. 2017 has to get kicked off, because we've had a few disastrous sessions so far, but that's just fishing for you, isn't it really? But tactics I'm using today, I'm basically using a variation of my combi rig. I mean, I usually use like an IQ2 fluorocarbon to a really supple braid. I've literally sort of like moved away from that at the moment. I like the rig, but I've had a few mishaps, so to speak. So I've now went on to ESP semi-stiff. Like, you've probably seen me use it in previous blogs. So we have the ESP semi-stiff, and I've stiffed it back by about 10mm, just under the shank of the hoop. And it gives you that same effect. It's giving you that stiffness of the little boom section, but it's giving you the suppleness around the hoop, which is what I wanted. That's coupled with a sticky bait wafter and a piece of fake corn, which you've seen me use many times to great success, and it's literally my go-to bait. And on the other rod is just the other faithful multi-rig with a 15mm pink pop-up on it, which, you know, will hopefully do the do as well, because that's a pretty good rig, let's face it. Multi-rig is a really good rig. There's looks like someone's caught in a tree, sorry. Yeah, so done now. That's got like a little PV bag. I'll show you throughout the blog, obviously the rig, and I will try and show you some other bits that I've also bought a lot of stuff from Sticky Sharp Tackle. And as you know, I'm a team member of at the moment. He also does great deals throughout the weekend, so if you ever want some decent tackle, just give him a bell, or get him on Facebook, anything like that, you know, message him. He's a genuine fella. He'll sort you out, not a problem, and it's cheap enough. You know, and the quality's absolutely spot on. I wouldn't use it otherwise. Another thing that's just come up in the last few weeks is I'm also promoting a local tackle shop, Mersey Bait and Tackle. It's on Broome Scott Fishery. Now, I am in the process of getting a discount code to put into the blogs as well, so you can get your tackle and bait discounted. So they, you know, Dean, I think it's Danny, who runs the shop. They're being kind enough to do that for us, and they're also going to help us out with a lot of competitions as well. So big thumbs up to them, and show your support by going down there and getting some new stuff down there at a discounted price as well, eventually when I get the when I get our discount. So let's just see how today pans out. I mean, it's only not even 8 o'clock here, it's 10 to 8. I've been here just about half an hour or so. I've been here an hour, I've got here at 10 to 7. I've seen a few fish top up. Unfortunately, the way there's a lad opposite me, he's fishing in it, he's obviously done the night. I don't know where he's cast to, where the fish were topping, technically doing a nice swim, but I don't know where he's cast to, so I'm not just going to cast over him. I'm not that sort of angler. But that's something that we should all really put into our angling, is, you know, a bit of consideration for others. There's not enough of it going around. I mean, I've been to fish these where you don't really care, I'm casting over you, and that's one place why I won't go back to different venues. And a lot of you have suggested going to a certain venue, and basically I won't be going there for that reason, because the anglers that fish there just don't care about anybody else. Whereas I'm really considerate, because there was a lad down there this morning, for instance. He said, yeah, fish next to me, mate, but it was like in a corner as you walk in. I can't fish next to him. It's just, I don't want to spoil his chances, I don't want him spoiling mine. So fishing's a hobby at the end of the day. Let's just get on with it and be nice to one another, you know. Too much bitchiness in this world. Like, there's some ducks around here at the moment. Mark's not here today, he went up yesterday. I will be putting a little snippet of, well, not a snippet, but a little picture of what he caught yesterday. He had a good session, actually. He went down our little lake, and that duck just got caught in barbed wire. I wonder if you can take a duck home. I wonder if she'd be happy with that. Yeah, he went out yesterday, he had a really good session. Three of the lads that I talked to as well go down to certain places as well, and you know, the one lad's ripping it apart at the moment. I always wind them up saying, you're ripping it, leave some for the rest of us type thing. I won't say exactly what I say, because it's hard to swear on camera. So yeah, let's just see what's what. The plan was to get out with Mark today. Obviously, he's got weekend commitments, so it's half him. His missus works every weekend, so it's half him to get out. But we've got a few things lined up. I mean, we've got the lad from Northern Banks. He wants, our Mark has been talking to him while I've been away. We're trying to organise either a singles or a doubles match, probably a 24, maybe 48 hour, but we're looking for venues as well. So we're looking for that. We're also looking on doing like maybe a social as well somewhere, but venues is going to be an issue. I mean, by all means, throw me over some ideas of venues. Millbrook's one, Kellett Lake on Clearwater could be one, but that's just a day ticket only, so to turn up and fish only. So if someone's done a 24 hour, then we're sort of stumped on that one. And we really need someone where you can book a lake out. Cleverly Bridge as well, Tony the bailiff there, prop top fella, top bloke there, help you out to no end. He'd even join in, I supplied a beer, and well, not that I drink really, but he'd probably do a barbecue as well, depending on how nice it is. Obviously, he does for nothing, but I'll just weigh him in. So there's a few venues that we could do. So if you're interested, let me know either in the comments or on my Facebook page, just message me or just comment on the actual page. In regards to our competition as well, we're very nearly at 200 subscribers. So when that happens, there's going to be a prize coming up. Again, there's, you know, Mersey Bait and Tackle said they'll supply some prizes. I'm going to supply some prizes myself, whether it be a day out with us, 24 out with us, or even a place on our match. So we need to get that sorted, really. But as soon as we know any more, we'll keep you posted on that, because I've got a lot of guys, as you all know, you know, when you follow me or watch it, you're always messaging, let me know what's going on in your fishing life and stuff, and ask me when this match is going to be. I don't know yet. It'll probably be be after spawn, so after maybe the back end of the summer, probably, I would have thought so. What else? Any other orders of business that I need to talk to you about? We'll talk to you some of the rules of the competition. Rough draft of the rules. You need to like and subscribe to the YouTube channel, you need to like the Facebook page, and you also need to be an active subscriber. So basically, comment when the competition goes live. You need to comment in on that video, the comment box, and then I'll comment back. I'll give you the number. I'll do it on the Facebook page, just so I know. Be more ideal if you do it on the YouTube channel, to be honest. But you need to be an active subscriber. But you need to also tell me that you're on our Facebook page. But yeah, we'll see, that's a bit all over the place at the moment, so I'll iron them details out a little bit, and then we'll go from there. But, right, I'm going to see if I can encourage a bite somehow, because I haven't been watching the lake, and I really should be. So I'll get back to you in a bit with Riggs bait, and show you some products from Sticky Sharp Tackle, shall I? Well, I've only went and caught one. And it's a decent one as well. Well, when you see the colours on it, bloody stunning. I'm going to stop beating me up. Still a bit fresh because he's been resting in the net. But here we go. I'd say he's about £12 of common. £12 of common carp. Got a bit of a beaked mouth, but I'll tell you something, I'm pretty happy with this one. I was only standing by the rod as well. I was just replying back to some Facebook messages, and yeah, he rolled off. Pretty happy with this one. I'm going to get some stills. I'm getting back and I'll talk through the rig. Right, I'll run through the rig. Basically, excuse me, I'm crouching down here. Basically, what I've got is I've got about 18 inches worth of tungsten. Yeah, tungsten tubing from Corda. It's a gravelly brown one. I wasn't too fussy what it was, but it matches me leg clip. Whether you can quite see that. Little 2 ounce flat pair lead. Then I've got about 6 inches worth of a semi-stiff tungsten coated braid from ESP. I've got, that's actually a split shot with a bit of putty moulding around it. And then this is like a Julian Condliff type of multi-rig, because he uses string tube on his. I'm sorry, just moving the that's the one, the D further up, so you can quite see that. Got more fingers, sorry. So you've got that there, and then I'm hooking on a bit of a bag, Sticky Sharp Tackles PVA, straight, just hooking it straight on. See if I can go through it twice if I can. Yeah, there we go. Goes through just like that. Cast it in. Hope for the best. Well, I hope for the best. It's going on the right spot. And it produced the goods, so let's do it again. Well, after nothing was happening, I could see loads on the surface. I thought I'd come round to next door, see if there was any fish. There was fish, but I didn't get them from the top. I just snuck them in. Alright, it's probably only about £6. But more than welcome. I think he's a male fish because he's bloody powerful. I don't know. But I'm more than happy with this one. So, yeah, opportune catcher really. Just went next door, seen a load of them sitting under the tree. Flicked a little multi-rig out with a size 6 Sticky Sharp Tackle Curve and CC more Dirty Cream. And listen, no more than 30 seconds later, me rod nearly went in. It was a good job my foot was on the back end of it. So I'm going to get a few stills, get them back with the dot, and see if we can grab another one.
Right, okay, as you can see, I'm in the car. It's another session over, but it turned out to be quite a good session, actually. So, I had three runs, lost one, landed two. Upon close inspection of my first fish, which I honestly thought was about 12 pounds, 11 pounds maybe. Looking at some of the photos that I took on this, it probably looked like it was a scraper double, to be fair. It just looked big in the hand, so pictures don't lie, you know, tell a thousand words, don't they? So, yeah. Nevertheless, a couple of things that I should really talk about as well. So we've got our match slash social, probably more of a social at the moment. We've got that coming up now. Millbrook is probably looking the favourite at the moment for all that. So yeah, we've got Millbrook coming. Me and Mark will have to sort out the date. So we'll sort the date out for that. Obviously I'll get back to you on it. But you know, as I said before, probably be the back end of summer maybe. The stars have got to align for me and Mark really to go fishing together at the moment. Whereas I can book time off, but weekends I'm busy for weekends either with the family or working for myself, so it is what it is in that sort of respect. What's the other thing I need to talk to you about? I'm actually selling my beloved Delcams. So if anyone is interested in a set of three Delcams and the receiver and the D-Docs, which is basically you can put them on the buzz bars quicker. You know, they just click and click off instead of screwing them up and all that kind of stuff. Now I will be selling them, so just message me on Facebook, I prefer, because I won't be giving prices out on the comment section on YouTube, won't be doing that. So if you're interested, let me know. I'm also selling my ammo as well, my tracker ammo. And I've not long got it, but as you've seen, I've hardly used it. So if you're anybody's interested in that, let me know. Obviously, we'll not be posting that or the Delcams. They'll be local pickup only, really. Obviously, because they weigh so much and the ammo weighs a bit. So whether it weighs 2 kilos or I think it's 11. You know, it's gonna cost a fortune for anybody to sort of come and collect it and deliver it and all that kind of stuff. So, yeah. But on recap to this session, it's been spot on. You know, I couldn't have asked more. I've worked hard on it today. Really, I mean, I've moved a few times. I gave a bit of advice to the fella fishing next door to me. He moved into my original swim, and I said, well, I baited up here. And he fished on the first spot that I fished from and got that common this morning, and he got himself a 12 pound common, 11 pound common, I don't know what it weighed, I can't remember what it weighed, but I've got the photos on here, so I shall throw that in at the end for you to watch, to see. So I think that's pretty much it. I don't know when the next time I'm getting out is. I'm hoping it's going to be in the next couple of, well, the next weekend or two. Obviously next weekend's bank holiday weekend, so I'm either A, working, or well, I don't know, this sun is cracking me up, there we go. Yeah, so I'm going to be working or spending time with the kids, because obviously, because I've been on honeymoon, you know, I've obviously seen them all the time now, but you know, I don't spend enough time with the kids at the moment, to be honest. But I'm hoping, fingers crossed, I'm hoping to get a night ticket for the eventually, because it's easy for me to get to, really. I mean, it's even easier than the beer to get to be honest. I can be here quicker, and I can literally set up pretty quick, and it's only a limited membership as well, so it's not too bad, and the rules aren't daft either. I'm on them here again for another year. It's a yearly membership, so I'm on that for another year, so I will be fishing here probably on and off, probably not as much as what I thought it was going to be, but that was the other thing I was going to say as well, with regard to me saying that this year I'm going to try my best to catch a 30, I'm not going to bother, I'm not even going to attempt it at the moment. I just want to get out and fish. You know, I've got so many things that I want to do. Me and I'm getting asked because the page and the channel is getting a lot more popular. Me and Mark are getting asked to do a lot of socials, a lot of matches, a lot of promotional work as well. So limited fishing time, sort of like blog time as well. Although the way I fish on my blogs is for me anyway. It's never going to change. It's always going to be what you see on the session is what happens on the session. I don't edit them all together unless I do like the odd little after work ones. Then I might just mash them all together. But I don't know where my after work is going to be at the moment anyway, if I do any. So if the 30 comes along, it comes along, but I'm not fishing any venues with 30s in at present. I do want to go to a couple of different places this year. I want to fish Wyre, want to go back to Baden, Millbrook I wanted to go to anyway, the Mere, I want to go there again. So there's quite a few, there's a few things that we need to do, but if anyone, by the way, if anyone is actually interested in any more clothing or cups and all that kind of stuff, let me know. Mugs, should I say. I can get that sorted. The prices have differed a little bit because I got messed around by my first supply and now my second supply is pretty good. The wait's a little bit long. I can get them quicker, but it'll cost more type thing. So I'd rather just wait. I don't buy them in bulk in stock, so I don't have them in the house, so to speak. So literally when you order them, I order them, and then ESA. So if you do happen to have any of the clothing as well, if you catch, then send either me or Mark like privately a photo or put it on the page, and then give us a little write up of what you want, and then we'll put it on the page for you, and so on and so forth. And with regards to hitting our 2,000 subscribers, active subscribers, should I say, then you know, I think we're about, I don't know, just under 20 away or something like that. Like, so we're pretty close to that. So if we can get that sorted, if we can hit that, then you know, our little competition is probably going to be probably a day out with me and Mark, obviously paid by me and Mark. I'll see if I can grab some tackle off Sticky Sharp Tackle, and maybe a bit of bait from Mercy Bait and Tackle as well. So it's literally a full package. You'll get a day out with me and Mark, and you will get a bit of tackle and a bit of bait as well. So, and I will be doing other little bits like you win the new Sticky Bait Signature Square Pop-Ups. If I can get me on some of them, I'll do a little competition for them as well, like a bumper one. Then I'll do little things like that. If that's what everyone wants. I mean, if you don't want it, then that's fine. But I'll have to iron out the details on how I'm gonna actually do that, because I think the only issue with that is obviously with everyone liking and sharing and subscribing and all that, which is what I need, which is what I want. I need everyone to really do that on Facebook as well, if you could. But I need you to comment on the YouTube channel. So as soon as you comment on the YouTube channel, then you entered into the draw straight away. I'll either A, give you the number, or I'll just write your name down on a piece of paper, and we'll I don't know, I'll get kids to do like picking a name out of a hat type thing. But yeah, so things are looking bright at the moment. Fishing is now type thing, because spring has sprung, and it's everywhere was active. I mean, today was bloody active on there. It was black with them, especially down this end, the gate end of the lake. It was literally black with them out there, and everyone was fishing on the bottom. I think it was only me that was actually trying to get them off the top. It didn't work because I was fishing free line on the pop-up, and I could probably cast about 10 yards with it. So yeah, that was didn't really work as well as what I thought it would do. So that is another session coming to an end. So if you like what you see, like, subscribe and share, and I'm hoping I'll see you all on the bank sometime.